Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here in the Umar Hills. There's the inn. Supposedly evil mage home here. The minister, I guess the leader of the place there. I'm gonna head back over here. There's Ranger Cabin. We're just looking around and fought some... kind of near the end of the last episode, we fought some shadows and shadow fiends over there. They weren't too tough.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Of course, having said that, we'll probably just run smack dab into a lich or something like that, but... what can you do? Oh. Heavy traffic with the deer here. Well, that's pretty cool, walking across the logs and stuff. All that yelling. Huh. Ranger Cabin. Is there a way into it?
I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
Maybe a secret opening?
You know, I think the forest likes Boo.
Oh, that's the entrance. The forest likes Boo?
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
I mean, the first Baldur's Gate, it was Boo likes the forest. Now the forest likes Boo. Good to know it's, you know, reciprocated. Is that coming from outside or in here? It faded out. We got some kind of scroll over here, just laying on the ground or floor. Why did you stop detecting illusions? I didn't tell you to stop doing that.
Fleet of foot and all that.
A fire agate gem. Ooh. Some kind of bastard sword that looks pretty valuable. See if we can figure out what this is. We have a lot of scrolls, but Airy has it memorized, the spell. Taragarth the Bloodbrand plus one. Dungeon delving Lahorgan was lucky indeed to discover this Halruin blade in the ruins of the ancient sorcerer Cullon's haunt. For it would save his life that very day. The ghost of Cullon himself attacked the intruder, but the flames that followed only singed, absorbed into the glowing blood brand. Concealing himself, Lahorgan watched in amazement as the ancient sorcerer tried to divine his location, and again the sword protected him. Surviving this brush with death, the young man used this second chance, and the gold from selling the blade to, as he put it, get the hell out of adventuring. Okay, the fire resistance, 50%. Non-detectable by magical means such as detect invisibility and scrying. 2d4 plus 1 slashing damage, and that go plus 1. Not sure how good it is. That's definitely better. That's definitely better. Isn't it? Yeah, 1d8 plus 2. Let's bag it.
It must be crushing to your flimsy spirit.
Ugh.
That once you soared with eagles on wings crafted by angels, and now you're but a sad urchin covered in dust of an earth you once rode wind above.
Baconia, really?
Baconia, why are you so cruel? There's absolutely no reason to be so foul and petty, no reason at all!
Stop whining, Magpie. Oh, terribly sorry. Bird metaphors are forbidden because you can't fly anymore. Yo! I wish I could tell you you're being a complete jerk and to cut it out, but I can't. Alright. We can grab that from here. A note from Mazzy Fenton. Well,
all the world is blind to my passing.
It looks as if a violent struggle has taken place here. Someone was killed and dragged out of the cabin. There are a few footprints in the blood. They appear to be dog or wolf prints. Huh. Maybe werewolves.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Yeah, it seemed completely unrealistic to just grab it from there. Magical bolts look like of lightning. Merella's journal. Nice. In Merella's cabin, I found a journal by the ranger and a note left by the adventurer I heard of earlier named Mazzy Fenton. Left, it seems, for the unfortunate corpse present in the cabin. Oh, left for that corpse? Both seem to implicate that a wolf pack is responsible for the killings, and both Merella and Mazzy went onward to investigate this pack and have not returned. It seems likely that if I follow the directions given, I may find the answers to this mystery. Hmm. Well, we didn't read it yet. Some acid arrows there. It seems to be that we might find a hidden, like an illusory wall, hidden door. But he's not finding anything like that. She's been holding on to this stuff. Yeah, bolts of lightning. All right, let's read the note first. Walag? It's a W, I think. We travel this day to search out the wolf lair. My own scouting of the region has confirmed Morella's suspicions that there is a large pack of wolves acting in this area. On the map included, I have indicated where I believe the wolf den to be located. Follow if you can, but be cautious. We can ill afford another mysterious disappearance until we meet again. Mazzy. On the same sheet is drawn a crude but effective map which indicates the path to a forested area several hours north of the Imnes Vale region. Huh. Hours north. So is it not on this map? It's on another map? Merella's Journal. You skip many of the entries of times and places far removed from your current worries. Flame Rule 7. Katya came to visit again, a sweet child, eager to learn my ways with the wild creatures. Flame Rule 12. Dark creatures roam the forests. Several townspeople have been slain by some unknown predator. Everyone seems to have their own opinion on what is doing the killing. The strangest thing is that the bodies are disappearing in the morning. This leaves me baffled, for most signs point to a pack of wolves that have been in the area for a long time. Wolves don't steal bodies. Unless they're going to eat them. In which case, they steal them right after they kill them, not in the morning. Flame Rule 13. Or perhaps, I should say wolf-like creatures. At night, while I've been patrolling, I've often caught shadowy glimpses of these wolves, quote-unquote, running alongside me. I've tried to attract their attention, but they ignore me. I find this most strange, as if the pack is being controlled by someone else. Years ago, I spoke with the pack leaders, and they were cordial. Now they either flee from me, or, and I fear to say this, they stalk me. She spoke to the pack leaders. So is it like a druid or ranger, speak to animals kind of thing? Or can they actually speak common? Flame Rule 21. It is near noon, and still the wood outside my cabin seems full of shadows. Shadows and shadow fiends. I've been hard-pressed to hear birds, and most of the larger animals have long fled. I plan to find the wolves' den this afternoon. I've drawn a map to it. All signs point to them as being the culprits, but what wolves act like these? They are wolves with the cunning of men. And there is something else, a whispering in my mind. It is faint now, in the waking hours, but while I sleep, I dream only of this voice and the face behind it. Whether it is connected to the voices, I do not know. I suspect by the time the sun sets tonight, I'll have answers to my questions. I think Merella turned into a werewolf, I guess. I can't copy that one. Okay. Walag. So my journal. It's not in here. Oh, I still have to do this. Bring the acorns to the Fairy Queen. Oh, we need to follow up on this too. Wow, I forgot about it because it's hiding over in chapter 1. We've been just all in chapter 2. Alright.
Live by the sword! Stand back for justice!
That's not how that goes. Now over here is where we fought those shadows. Whoa. That brown bear just killed something. A groundhog, I guess? I've never seen that happen. Watch out for that brown bear. Really? I don't know. This is cool. It's been a while since we've, wandered around the countryside. Yeah, some weird noises. Ooh. That's weird looking. Oh, it's a squirrel. I just noticed the log here. How weird. And there's flies around and stuff. This is a cool theme. I like this. Is this something we climb? Apparently, yes.
Let us speak and be done with this.
Oh, you scared the crap out of me. Derek says, You're one of those wizard folk looking for Valygar, aren't you? Valygar who? Liar! Will not allow our employer to be hounded in this manner. Oh boy. Are they wizards too? What is he holding? Derek and Ranger. Maybe they're both Rangers. Alright. Let's see what they do. If they start throwing spells, I'm gonna throw a silence onto them. They are. Derek and one ranger have been silenced. Jahira made her save as well, good. Bolt of Glory. Sounds good. Who's who here? Ranger and Ranger. I'll aim it at this Ranger here. Derek's dead.
Nature's servant awaits.
Nature's servant is hurting.
I am willing.
All right. Healing here. I don't see a need to use up all these spells on these guys. Bring out the kneecapper. Defend me, the ranger says. I don't know who's calling on to defend him, but he's almost dead. Ranger down.
Yes. Nature, take the life she gave.
Defend him, huh? So I guess this might be the way to Valygar. Here we got a silver necklace. Magical flail. Gold ring. Some kind of mystical boots. Boots of the West? Apparently it's already identified. Split mail. Do not need. Another gold ring. Boots of the West. These are the boots that were once owned by the famous woodsman Randy of the West. Charisma plus one and immunity to disease. Alright. Like Randy of the Wood... Randy of the Woods? What's that guy's name? Randy... I think it is Woods. Randy of the Redwoods. Alright, for president, yeah. Alright, so, I don't know if that's a nod to him or not. Well, who doesn't have boots? Because you won't ever be diseased, right? Jahira needs boots. Aerie needs boots. I'll give them to Aerie. And then this mace, oh, flail, sorry. It's just a flail plus one. Okay. Well, that was interesting.
Fine.
Well, I'll take the plate mail, throw it in a bag of holding for later to sell. Alright, we need some healings here. That sounds like a brontosaurus or something. Maximum healing. You call me Kalis? Kalis is an ancient warrior of myth of the Klingon people. Okay, so... something just wear off or something? Alright, let's...
see battle, Bo! Run, Bo! Run!
Look at that. Do not turn hostile. It'll force to be destroy you. Get away. Watch out, deer. He's coming. Well, told you to watch out. This thing's on a rampage. And he's right in our way. Unless we can pass behind the house. So I wonder if this guy lurks within. There's a moose. Whoop. Valygar's cabin. Oh, wow. I'm a bit intimidated, I must say. There's the door. Somewhere over here. I just saw it for a second. There it goes. No other way in? Like we could take us...
I am still unused to all this green and fragrant brightness. Part of me yet looks for the hidden spider's web amongst all this.
Let's go in here after. Actually, yeah, I won't go in there after. We need a rest anyway. I want to be at full strength when we fight this guy. Oh, nice. Look at that. Those look like huge mushrooms. Like an isometric version of Morrowind or something. Can't walk over there. The hidden spider's web. Yeah, we might find it. Okay. Along the bank here, we found a way to get across. Oh. Minotaur? A gnoll? Madulf, and an ogre. So these are the ogres we were looking for. Although they're speaking with a minotaur and a gnoll, which is interesting. Hail, creatures! Who else is there? An ogre and an orc. There's a ring somewhere. Oh, the ring's over there. I guess it's realistic to say someone will just run over there and grab it. Oh, we're gonna do that.
Yoshimo is willing.
Just a silver ring. I'll keep it on my person. Might be significance. Just sitting here by them. And it is silver, which you think werewolves, but these are not werewolves.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
They're not reacting to us yet. Grr! We no harm! Grr! No one trouble! You speak Madulf! Sorry, guys. That was rough on my voice here. What is, does the Minotaur speak? I don't think those talk. Oh, they do. Oh, Madulfin's talking. Never mind. Hold, yous of not human village. Why you come? What yous wanting? I have a lot of questions. Who are you and what are you doing here? Me, Madulf, lead fellows from great army of Sithilis in the south. No want to kill races no more. Lead fellows in desertion. We wants to be left alone. Or we just wants be left alone. A third option. Well, I guess we'll get into a background a little bit. You deserters from the Sithilician Empire? How do you expect to live up here? It's very hard. Humans hates us, and we just want to be left alone. Some humans call knights, who chase us. Not bad here, but Madulf thinks village will call knights soon. Humans very mad. I'm gonna guess they're not killing them. It's not them, but yeah, I'm not gonna say any of these other things. Especially 2 and 3. Of course they have a right to be mad if you're killing them. We no kill no humans in village. We no want trouble with yous. How do I know you're telling the truth? Always Madulf and fellows be chased and hated, cause me and Ogre, we just wants be left alone. We come here 1 moon ago, tries to settle for a while, yes? Soon after we come, fellows begin to vanish. 1, 2, they go. Some turn up killed, skin missing. Some bodies vanish, too. Madulf no, who killing us. Madulf worried. Numbers get smaller. We like here, but something bad is here, too. Killing us fellows. Very bad. Something's killing your people, too? What do you think it is? Madulf no knows. Maybe wolves. Maybe bad magics. Nobody see what kills fellows. Comes at night, though. Maybe is the shadows. I see. So your band is no better off than the village. Are we going, then? Wait. You not attack us. We need you bring word to human village. Humans run when Madulf goes, so me needs yous to do it for me. Yous bring word, yes? He kind of talks like people in Brooklyn. What kind of word do you need brought to them? Madulf no want death. Madulf no want fight. Just want peace. You tell villagers, maybe, that Madulf and fellows will protect village. Protect from orcs in mountains, yes? Well, that would be a lie, because we don't know if it's orcs in mountains. Humans let us stay then, and no call knights. Maybe let us come, once in a moon, to trade for food and goods. Madulf make deal with village. If yous tell them, we no want trouble. Alright, I'll tell the mayor what you've said, but I can't promise anything. Madulf happy. Maybe fellows can live alone and eat good. Be happy here. You do good thing. Maybe humans agree. Madulf, keep deal, you tell them. Yeah, but they still got these things hunting them, so it's not like you can be happy there unless we kill them as well. Madulf must make a deal with the village. It seems obvious that Madulf and his followers are not responsible for the deaths in Imnis Vale. If he can be believed, some of his people were murdered as well. I mean, why is it obvious? He has no proof. I do believe him. The Ogre has asked me to bring word to Minister Lloyd and tell him that he wishes an alliance. Madulf and his followers will protect the village from the orcs in the hills if the villagers will leave them in peace and let them trade occasionally. I have promised to bring this proposal before the mayor, but we have not promised anything. Yeah, that's wise. It's wise not to promise anything like that. Minotaur says, use no attack! No attack! We want left in peace! All want! Go speak, Madulf! Was this... And what if these ogres have anything to say? Ogre and orc, sorry. You business, you speak to Madulf. Madulf, lead us away from syphilis. Well, that's a good thing. That's a very bad venereal disease. You don't want that. Don't want trouble. You speak Madulf. You have business with us, yes? It's good to see you again, human. You bring word to human village, yes? Not yet, but I intend to. It's good. Madulf thinks maybe he and fellows can stay. Live in peace, maybe. If humans not hunt us down, that is. We protect. We keep word. Yeah, I'll remember that. Well, we have a little bit more to explore. We have to take on Valygar's cabin and Jeremian's home. And we have to go talk to Minister Lloyd. But at least some of that stuff will be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.